Hello, travel agents. We have had several requests from you to give you some ideas, tips, and tricks about how to use Evernote for your travel agency. So today I'm going to do just that. Now, this is not a video about the how-tos of Evernote, the technical aspect of it. Evernote has fantastic training and tutorial videos, so if you need tips about how to create a notebook, how to file things, how to organize it, go to evernote.com and search for that. Or, of course, you can always ask us a question in the comments, and we're happy to help you out as much as we can. All right, so let's get started. So the first thing you want to do is, if you don't have an Evernote account, go to evernote.com and sign up for an account. Really, the basic plan is what I recommend starting with, and once you play around with it for a little while, you might realize that you want some of the features of the Plus or the Premium plans. I personally use the Plus plan right now, but the basic is totally fine, and I use that for several years. The other thing that I recommend you getting is an app for your phone or your tablet, and it's called Scannable. And this is a fantastic app that is literally like a scanner in your pocket, and you can scan documents. I use it to scan receipts, paperwork, everything. I'm almost paperless business and household, and I use the Scannable app all the time. It allows you to scan notes and either email them, save them to your phone, or send them right to your Evernote account. It's fantastic. And one more thing I recommend getting is the Evernote Web Clipper for Chrome, and I'll show you how I use all these things in this video, and I'll also put the links to them below this video so you can access them quickly. But I just wanted to show you those are the three things that I recommend you have: is the Web Clipper, the Scannable app, and of course you need Evernote itself. Once you get Evernote, I would download the app for your computer. You can access evernote.com, which is great because any computer you're at, anywhere, you can log into your evernote.com account online and access all your notes. I personally just prefer to work on the app, which is what this is. So this is just on my computer, and this is where I prefer to work, but it's totally up to you. I do recommend you have the app. It's even if nothing else, it's kind of an extra backup for you. Okay, so the first thing that I want to show you. So I'm in Notebooks right now, as you can see. And one specific question we get asked pretty frequently is about canned email responses. So I have a notebook set up for canned email responses. Now what this is for a place to store emails that you regularly send so that you're not reinventing the wheel every time you need to send an email. Either an email that you initiate just because it's something you frequently send, like we send testimonial requests to our clients on a regular basis, or if it's a response, like if you get the same question all the time from clients and you find yourself always writing the same response, just save that in your canned responses. And then when you get that question, you just copy it, paste it, edit it for that client, and send it. It saves you tons of time. So what I do is in the subject line here, I put, or the title of the note, I put what it is. So this is my testimonial request email. This is the travel website complete email. So this is what we send to clients when their websites are done. It has lots of good information about their website. So let me show you exactly how I use this. I put the subject line right here. So I'm just gonna copy the entire email, and I'm gonna go to my inbox, compose an email, paste it, and then I will copy the subject line, delete that, and then you just add their name. Again, I would scroll through it to make sure there's nothing that you need to change for that particular client. Put in their email address and click send. How much easier is that than composing this email every single time? So you can just collect, you can have a whole collection of wonderful canned responses in here. This is actually not where our company keeps all of our canned responses. We use another tool for this so that we all can share it easily. But I will tell you that we have hundreds probably of canned responses that are organized and are very searchable so that anything that comes up, we can go there, find an email that's already been written and edit it a little bit and send it to the client. It's a really great way to just save yourself a lot of time. Now, we always edit them and make sure that they make sense for that client, but we do save a lot of our emails to save us time and to save us from rewriting the same thing over and over again. So the next thing I want to show you, speaking of writing, is you can use Evernote for writing your blog posts. So I don't use Word or Pages. I compose all my blog posts in Evernote. I have a writing stack, and within this writing stack, I have several folders. I have one for a journal and one for my blog posts. So when I'm going to write a new blog post, I just click New Note in Blog Post. And if I don't have a title yet, I'll just start with a working title, whatever I want that to be. And then you just start writing, and you can come in and edit it. You don't have to save it. It just saves real time. Another trick, so I'll have several blog posts going at the same time. Some never go anywhere. Some of them are just ideas that pop into my head and I stick them in here. But once they're finalized and posted, I just add posted to the end of it so I know that's their status. They've been posted. It's easy as that. The other way to use Evernote for business and even personal is to save your receipts. Now remember I talked about that scannable app? So what we do is scan every receipt that comes in, we scan it with a scannable app, send it to Evernote, and save it in. Each year has its own folder. So you can see I created a receipts 2016 and then tax related 2016, and they're in a receipts 2016 stack. And so this is what scannable looks like. So you can see our shopping habits. And it's just as easy that you just send the receipt to Evernote and then we throw away the receipt. I have returned stuff using an Evernote copy of the receipt. Now I can't guarantee that every store is going to let you do that, but we have done that. We've been successful with that in the past. The other way I use Evernote is for meeting notes, or even if I'm at a conference, I would put, let's see, for staff meetings, I do staff meeting, let's see, 9, 10 of 16. That would be my title, and then I would just take notes right here. And one tip that I really love is if it's something that I need to do or to remember for later, create Evernote video, and then you can add, go to format and click insert to do, and insert this little checkbox so that you don't forget. And actually Evernote allows you to search by open to do's. So that way, you know, if they're kind of lost, if your to do's are kind of lost in your notes, you can easily search that way and find things that you needed to remember to do and pull them out. I also take conference meeting notes this way, all meeting notes, and training or class notes you can put right here in Evernote. Another great way that I think that travel agents could benefit from Evernote is organizing information on destinations. So to give you just a brief idea about how I use Evernote for travel, we're avid travelers. We're currently traveling the country, the U.S., in an Airstream travel trailer. So in my travel notebook, I have Airstream. I have things specific to full-time travel. I have packing information. And then I have notes about things to do and see in each state. So I have a note for every state, and I'll just put notes in there about interesting things that I've heard about in those states. In my packing, I have kind of packing inspiration, and I also keep packing lists for every major trip we take. And then I write what we packed, and then I make notes about what we didn't need or what we missed. But you could use this for, you could easily have like each notebook be a destination, a different destination, however you want to track information. And that's the great thing about Evernote. Put stuff in here, play around with the organization, rearrange it. You know, in 6 months, if it's just not working for you anymore, just rearrange it and restructure it so that it works for you again. Evernote is very fluid, very easy to edit, which makes it really nice. It's organic, it grows and moves with you and your business. One more thing I'm going to show you, and this is about that Evernote web clipper. So I read a ton online. I do a lot of research online, and when I find an article that I love, instead of just saving the link, because you know if you save the link, it doesn't guarantee that that link's not going to go away, because if the owner of the website takes it down, then you've lost that content. So what I do is you just, once you download the Evernote web clipper, you just click on the little elephant, and then you can choose article, or you can choose simplified article. They just kind of save it in two different ways. And then you choose what notebook you want it in, and I'm going to put it in writing how to. You can add a tag if you use tags. You can add comments like, love this article, great copywriting info. And sometimes I'll put comments just because I know like later I'm going to search a certain term to find it. Or maybe I just want to make a note, like remember to look at XYZ. And then click save. So the first thing this does is save it to your Evernote.com. So then if you want it to show up on the app, you'll sync it. So that's what that is right there. It's going to sync your Evernote.com account to your computer. And then there it is. It's right there in your most recent note. All right, those are the main tips that I wanted to share with you today. It's a lot. I love Evernote. There is so much more I could share. This video could be 3 hours long, but I just wanted to give you some top tips that I think that as travel agents you can use to be more productive and make your life a little bit easier. Let us know if you have any questions. Thank you so much.